The State Department of Transportation is planning big changes for a popular intersection in Malden. It's an intersection where a woman has sold produce and other local items for decades. And she is worried that these changes may change where people choose to spend their money.
We sell pumpkins, Christmas trees, live bait.
In her 30 years operating the Malden Open Air Market, where you can find everything from produce to locally packaged items, Joanne Chandler has used signs to set some ground rules.
No cussing, no smoking, no book bags inside.
And recently, she posted a new sign on Butler Road.
This is my business, my livelihood, which I'm trying to protect and preserve.
She says the State Department of Transportation's plans to widen the intersection where Butler Road meets Corn and Bridges Roads, right near Malden High School, would shorten her business.
They're talking about taking this whole triangle off from this tree over here to here.
Joanne says the plans would eliminate much of the parking space.
Nobody wants to see this place go out of business, and if people have that much trouble getting in and out, you know, eventually they won't come.
Joanne says the DOT also wants to cut off a portion of her property that her more than 70-foot tractor trailer uses to deliver produce by converting this embankment into an access driveway. But she says that option is not a safe one.
It's going to be hard for us to even get out in the road without red lights.
She has a driveway on Corn that's right in the intersection right there.
But Tommy Elrod with the DOT says the project will make the entire area safer.
I just like for those driveways where her trucks and her customers come in and out to be removed from those areas where you're going to have pedestrians crossing.
And this will go to Governor Haley.
Joanne has collected more than 1,000 signatures from others opposed to the project, a project that is not set in stone.
I'll continue to work with Ms. Chandler and try to come up with access that eases her concerns.
And construction is tentatively scheduled to begin next summer.